Bismillahir Rahmanir Raheem. Ati Allah, Ati Rasul, Ulul Amri Minkum. And always a reminder for myself, and Abdukal Ajis, a Da'ifu, Miskin, Uzal, and Mujahad. And but for the grace of Allah that we're still in existence, alhamdulillah, that Allah loaded the holy month of Safar with the immense souls. Like a video game that every level, every day we go into, Allah rewarding with immense new barakahs and blessings. That to have such holy souls in this holy month and to celebrate their life and their passing, their existence and their struggle, grants are their nazar to be upon us, their dress and their lights to be upon us, our families and communities. What could be a better life when Allah is describing to Prophet what we described last night. In Ayatul Kareem verse 28 of Surah Al-Kahf, Allah is, "Let not thy eyes and thy soul pass the people of remembrance whom day and night they're making their dhikr." And for the sake of the people of pomp and glitter, means that the nazar of Prophet that Allah is giving us an insight into the immense guidance that Allah, because Allah is the command of Prophet eyes. So Allah gives us an insight into how this is created, that I created this Muhammadan eyes and nazar and soul. Because when the soul gazes upon the servant, is dressing them and blessing them, it's not an empty vision. But Allah, be wary, be cautious of the believer, for he looks to people with the faiz of Allah. He looks with the lights and the emanations from Allah. What more powerful believer than the soul of Sayyidina Muhammad? So, unzur halana wa ishfalana, is that Allah is giving us the insight in that holy ayatul kareem, that His reality is to look to those whom make dhikrullah and not to pass them, and to be patient with them.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Shaykh Nurjan. Thank you for watching the video that you're watching. InshaAllah, if you're happy with the content and happy with these programs, please support the button below, the programs that we have for our orphanage repairs, our water well, give the gift of life, our mobile food vans. We have now 5 vans, Vancouver, Chicago, Los Angeles, Pakistan. There's many programs that reach thousands of people and rescue foods and give those supplies to people in need. Your support is greatly appreciated. Also, be so kind as to leave loving comments and please share the stream. Every bit counts. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
So, alhamdulillah, Allah even gives to us an immense reality that to be patient with them means that they're not always going to be great, they're not always going to be perfected, but they're the people of dhikrullah, that Allah put into their heart and gave a permission to remember Me. Remembrance of Allah is not on our own fruition, it's not our own cleverness. Surah An-Nur, Allah describes, "I give permission for them to mention My name within their homes." Their home, the ultimate home for the believer is his heart. So the mere fact that somebody can say, "Allah, Allahu Akbar," is Allah's gift. It's not a cleverness, it's not somebody say, I don't want to say that." So no, you can't say it. So don't think you're clever. If Allah doesn't give you permission, it will never come off onto your tongue to say. So means whom Allah grants that blessing and that ni'mat, immense gift and grace, then Allah is then describing, then be patient with them. In that ayatul kareem Allah is using the word sabr, but have sabr and patience with them, these ones whom they busy themselves with dhikrullah. And then the immensity of that, because we've gone into it, that what is the dhikr of Allah? Salawat al-Sharif, because the dhikr for you is to say Allah, but the dhikr of Allah is in Allahi wa malaikatuhu yusalluna ala nabi. The rest is optional for you. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This one is optional, but Allah's dhikr is in Allahi wa malaikatuhu yusalluna ala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So then Allah is giving the depth of that reality that I created the soul of Prophet to gaze upon those whom making durood al-sharif. Because the other clever hizb al-shaytan come and say, dhikrullah is salah when we pray. So, no, salah is salah, dhikrullah is a praising upon Allah, and then real dhikrullah is what is the dhikr of Allah. When Allah gives to us, what is Allah's type of praise? And it's Sayyidina Muhammad, it's salawat, durood al-sharif upon Prophet. So they can't say this is prayers, they can't say this is reading Qur'an, they can't say that, oh, this is this and this is that. No, Allah give to the heart of Prophet and heart of awliyaullah that no, this dhikrullah is durood al-sharif. Then Allah put into the code of Prophet that look for these people whom making salawat upon you. So the laser, because Prophet has no will of his own, the perfect in servanthood. So Allah's giving us the clue and the key, if you want this nazar like a guaranteed laser to come to you, it's already been programmed that the nazar and the gaze of Prophet seeks out those who make dhikrullah. And the real dhikr of Allah is the salawat upon Sayyidina Muhammad. And it seeks out that light and dresses them and overlooks anything of pomp and glory. Because people say, oh, but look at those, they have like stadiums when they talk, they're like this. This is Wahhabi people, they have crowds and masses of people because shaitan sends all his people to them so that they can go onto the earth and be aggressive and destroy the haqqaiqs of Islam. Because of their aggressive nature, bad character, bad manners, anytime you see somebody with bad manners, they do a detriment to Islam, they have a destruction of Islam. I've seen somebody who calls himself a big scholar in the UK and sits and uses his knowledge to insult somebody. He has on the other table look like the person is going to be a mufti or a shaykh or somebody, he's wearing a turban and he wants to immediately come out like these fights with animals and begin to attack somebody and humiliate the opponent and degrade the opponent. And ask from Prophet was knowledge ever supposed to be used as a weapon like that? And a weapon that you unsheath your sword against a fellow Muslim, you use knowledge against ignorance, even with hikmah, because it never comes out a sword. You don't use your knowledge to cut people down, but you use your knowledge to prompt people up, to give hope to people, to be humble in your approach. So that not to humiliate, because Allah says, don't speak harshly lest they come back and say something harsh about your Lord. So it means these are the finesse of manners. That's when we talked before that this way of Ashab al-Kahf, The first door is manners, because from this point on if the servant doesn't have manners, all the knowledge in the world is of no benefit to him nor anyone whom listens to him, because it's going to be used to harm people, enter into debates to deface and demean and lower people. For what? Shaitan already does that to people. What do you want the person, take their turban, take and shave their beard and then go to nightclub and you would be happy? Already shaitan is working that direction. So it means uloom and knowledge is based on hikmah, that they have a hikmah, they feel shy from what Allah has given to them and knows that this is a powerful weapon and medicine, and it's only to be used to raise people, to give them hope, to give them the assurities of paradise, the assurity of the love of Allah and the love for Sayyidina Muhammad. So in this ayatul kareem Allah is giving us, He's like, for us, for the tech people who want to understand, if you want this nazar, it's like an autopilot, it's been programmed. Because Prophet has no desire from his own uhi al-Qur'an, that he represents Allah, his tongue is in complete submission to Allah, holy eyes are in complete submission to Allah. If you want to call that Divinely laser Allah, then describing, then be the people of tafakkur, be the people of dhikrullah, in which they sit on the bench, the people of the bench, they were sitting and meditating, contemplating, making their salawat and durood sharif. And Allah reminded Prophet ﷺ, don't pass your eyes, not to pass them for the more popular people. That ayah is inherited for all Muhammadiyoon, means holy companions and these big huge awliya. So when somebody asks that, why you have to celebrate their birthday, why are you going on the street and giving some sandwiches and food and drinks? Because ayatul kareem is a description of their reality, that if they become Muhammadiyoon, their eyes, their ears, their breath is all programmed by Prophet ﷺ, not from their own desires. So then they become representatives of that blessed ayah, in which you do good, you remember them on their birth and on their passing, and what happens? Like a laser, that nazar comes to you. It's been guaranteed by the people of goodness. Then what Allah describes, ooh, how am I gonna find that now? In the people of goodness, that these people of goodness, whatever good they do, Allah rewards them. Every action. Call upon their Lord with evening. Then ayah kareem is 18th verse of Surah Al-Kahf, 30th, 18th surah, verse 30, Hajji Shahid. That these good people, these people of dhikrullah, what Allah now grants to them?
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات إنا لنصيع أجر من أحسن عملا صدق الله العلي العظيم.
Mubarak to Rasul Kareem and to those who believe and they work righteousness. Means those people of the dhikr, in which the nazar is supposed to be upon their souls. And holy souls seek out these people of dhikrullah. And Allah is describing, and those who believe and do righteousness, verily we shall not let any of your good deeds to be lost, not a reward of it will be lost. Anything that you do, any single deed that you do in righteousness will be blessed. So means Allah is giving to whatever deed you do, these people of dhikrullah, of goodness, Allah will grant an immense reward, immense reward. Even they give a cup out of water, even they give a grain of bread, even if they give a salams and a smile, a good character to people, Allah is then giving that your reward is set aside, you are granted immense rewards. Why? Because these nazars upon you. If the nazar and the gaze and the Divinely gaze of Prophet is upon servants, and the Muhammadiyoon means his Ahlul Bayt, his holy companions, and awliya Allah fi samahi wa fil ard, they're all in that same ayah, that every time their eyes and their soul are looking for these people of dhikrullah, in which they only want the holy face of Allah, they want to improve themselves, they want to make their dhikr, their salawat, their durood. And Allah is granting all these holy faces will always be looking for you, and everything that you do in righteousness will be rewarded. So somebody said, oh, it's just a cup of water. Allah says, in every cup you gave, Allah will count every drop that came from that cup. Allah wants to multiply the rewards of a servant. He doesn't give the reward based on the cup you drank, but for every molecule of water that came out from that tap is a dress and a blessing upon the servant. Every bite of food that somebody eats from generosity and from generous servants, these people of dhikrullah, when they go out and feed people, when those people go home and they eat, every bite they eat has 300 angels making shifa and intercession for the people whom are eating. What about then the reward of those angels written upon the servant who gave the food? This is Allah giving them now the understanding that if the one who ate your food has 300 angels blessing him, those 300 angels' praisings are upon that person whom gave the food, the person of dhikrullah, every bite. So if there was 1,000 bites in a meal, those angels are all dressing upon the servant who gave that food. So means the ajran azim, that we can understand the immensity of Allah wanting to give the benefit to these people of dhikrullah, that all these holy souls watching you, all these holy souls praying for you. Don't think about the people of pomp and all those important looking people. I've already programmed the eyes not to look at them. They're looking and seeking out the people of dhikr. And then Allah says, everything these people do will have an immense reward and be granted immense gifts. And Mawlana Shaykh would describe that, imagine every angel, 300 angels the person got in a bite, all making shifa and intercession for the one who's eating the food of a generous person. But the one who gave that food, that generous servant, is receiving the praisings of those 300 angels per bite that the servant is eating from. Every time they bite, the reward goes to the one who distributed the food and gave the food to these people, and gave water to people, gave hope to people, gave knowledge to people, gave good character. So it means it's all encompassing, it's not only the shaykh, it's all the shaykh's students, all the ambassadors of this reality. They said, we gave food and we came across people, we were polite, we gave water, we did every type of kind gesture, because we are the people of dhikrullah. And we are the people that want to be under the nazar of Nabi'een, Siddiqeen, Shuhada wa Saliheen. And then every good deed we do, Allah says, I'm with you. Every dress is upon that servant and that soul. We pray that Allah dress us with the immensities of these lights, the immensities of these holy nights, that encourage us on these holy nights. Sayyidina Ahmed Sirhindi al-Fithani is of an immense pillar, that if the pillar of Islam, the beginning of that pillar, the top Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, to the right Mawlana Sirhindi, and to the left into the heart Sayyidina Imam Mahdi alayhi salam, they hold this triangle together. And there are immense, immense poles of reality. That's why Allah is sending in the last days Sayyidina Mahdi salam, so that to carry the nation into its final phase. So it means these are immense souls, immense blessings, immense dressings, to give water for them, to give food for their sake, to do anything to be under their holy nazar. They're fulukul mashhoom, they're loaded ships with immense dresses and immense blessings, and nothing stops that blessing from reaching us other than just good deeds. So it's not something that we have to jump through hoops to receive these, they have these blessings filled in their hearts and in their souls. And all that Allah inspire within us, go out and do good deeds for that sake, remember them. Even in your majlis when you sit together, remember like we're remembering tonight, and that should entitle us to their nazar, their blessings and their dressings upon ourselves, our families that are not present with us or couldn't make it or not attending, and all of our communities. Bi hurmati Muhammad al-Mustafa wa bi siri Suratul Fatiha.
As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Shaykh Narjan, thank you for watching the video that you're watching. InshaAllah, if you're happy with the content and happy with these programs, please support the button below, the programs that we have for our orphanage repairs, our water well, give the gift of life, our mobile food vans. We have now 5 vans, Vancouver, Chicago, Los Angeles, Pakistan. There's many programs that reach thousands of people and rescue foods and give those supplies to people in need. Your support is greatly appreciated. Also, be so kind as to leave loving comments and please share the stream. Every bit counts. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.